Over the past few years, anti-aging science has been making massive leaps. Scientists have developed medical technologies to treat age-related diseases and, most importantly, aging itself. These technologies hold lots of potential to extend healthy human lifespan to beyond 100 years and thereby evolve humans beyond Homo sapiens into what Yuval Noah calls Homo Deuce. In this first part of a two-part series, I'll cover 4 of 8 emerging technologies that improve health and longevity. One of the most exciting and remarkable emerging anti-aging therapies is epigenetic reprogramming. Epigenetic reprogramming offers 2 main ways to rejuvenate cells, organs, and organisms: genetic and chemical approaches. The most common genetic approach includes Yamanaka factors, which are 4 genes whose products can reprogram cells to become younger. However, prolonged exposure to Yamanaka factors may lead to the formation of cancers known as teratomas. To address this hurdle, researchers have developed a short burst of Yamanaka factors called transient or partial reprogramming. Shorter bursts of Yamanaka factors can rejuvenate cells while minimizing their reversion to stem-like cells and consequently lowering the risk of cancer. One study saw a rejuvenation of around 30 years after applying Yamanaka factors to middle-aged human cells. In mice, adding Yamanaka factors before and during myocardial infarction or heart attack lowers damage to heart muscle and improves heart function. Most impressively, Yamanaka factors given to mice that age prematurely produced improved aging symptoms and prolonged lifespans. And modified Yamanaka factors given transiently to old mice, equivalent to over 70-year-old humans, improved their health and extended their lifespans by 109% compared to their non-treated peers. There are also chemicals that are being identified that can rejuvenate cells similarly to Yamanaka factors. Chemical approaches have many advantages over other methods, including easier control and standardization of treatments, easier manufacture, standardization, optimization of chemicals, and less concern with integration into the genome compared to DNA-RNA-based methods. The potential for epigenetic reprogramming to extend healthy lifespan in humans is so alluring that it has attracted billions of dollars, Nobel laureate scientists, and top entrepreneurs. While we are still years away from testing epigenetic or chemical reprogramming on human lifespan, supplements such as calcium AKG may activate Yamanaka factors and slow aging. Calcium AKG has shown promise in animal models to delay aging, including decreased gray fur, improved skin, and lower age-related bone conditions and cancer formation. Possibly more impressive are the results from a small human trial that showed calcium AKG improved biological aging. Keep your eyes out for progress in this area. Related to epigenetic reprogramming is the exciting field of gene therapy. Most scientists agree that aging is caused by roughly 20% genetics, which means the rest is due to the environment. This means that we all have genes and mutations that play roles in aging. Thankfully, we now have a tool, gene therapy, to manipulate our genes, which will help us alter our disease risks and aging fates. As the name implies, gene therapy is a method that alters a person's genes to treat or cure disease. There are 2 main uses for gene therapy to increase healthy lifespan. One is replacing or silencing a pro-aging gene, and the second is adding a new or modified copy of a pro-longevity gene. There are many pro-aging genes that seem to drive aging and increase our risk of death. Inactivating or lowering the levels of these gene products could improve our health and extend our lifespans. Take, for example, the PCSK9 gene, which encodes an enzyme that plays a role in controlling blood, low-density lipoprotein, cholesterol levels. Scientists found that inactivating this gene's product lowers blood cholesterol levels, thereby lowering the risk for cardiovascular disease. Now, a company called Verve Therapeutics is using revolutionary technology called CRISPR, which can edit precisely any letters in our genome to permanently turn off the PCSK9 gene. They found that their approach lowered blood PCSK9 protein by over 80% and LDL cholesterol by nearly 70% in monkeys, an effect that lasted nearly 1.5 years after treatment. Here's one more example. A recent study identified the CAT7 gene product as a pro-aging factor that increases in liver cells during aging and promotes formation of senescent cells, also known as zombie cells. Senescent cells are a type of cell that accumulates with aging, which can produce inflammation and promote aging. With the aid of CRISPR, the scientists turned off the Cat7 gene in older mice. They found that these treated mice were healthier, had better grip strength, improved behavioral response to anxiety, and most excitingly, increased lifespans. Now, what about adding genes to improve healthy lifespan? Scientists have been working on adding pro-longevity genes to tackle age-related diseases. One recent study showed that gene therapy with either TGFBR2, FGF21, or alpha-klotho, or a mix of the first two, can treat many age-related diseases, including obesity, type 2 diabetes, heart failure, and kidney failure. Other studies have targeted another key pro-longevity gene, TERT, which produces an enzyme that extends the ends of caps of our chromosomes, also known as telomeres. Scientists found that intranasal application or injection of the TERT gene into mice extended their median lifespans by over 40%. The same study found that gene therapy with FST, a gene whose product is important for muscle growth, extended median lifespan by over 30%. These treatments also improved physical performance and health characteristics in the mice. Based on these exciting and promising findings, some humans, like BioViva CEO Elizabeth Parrish, have sent caution to the wind and apparently started to treat themselves with these pro-longevity genes. While I recommend waiting for some more safety data, gene therapy looks like a very promising approach to extending healthy lifespan. For more content on emerging anti-aging therapies, make sure to hit the subscribe button. In what's probably the most Frankensteinish longevity experiment ever created, scientists found that connecting the blood circulatory systems of an old mouse with a young mouse improves many health markers and extends the lifespan of the old mice. The procedure is called heterogenic, meaning different aged mice, parabiosis, meaning creating a shared blood circulation by surgically attaching two organisms. Studies have found that this method caused rejuvenation of aged stem cells, better health or repair of many organs, including muscle, brain, spinal cord, skin, bone, and cartilage, improved biomarkers of aging, including epigenetic clocks and gene expression signatures. One epigenetic clock showed a decrease in epigenetic age of over 30% in old mice, and longer lifespans. Pretty cool. The promising effects of HP on health and lifespan extension in animal models has spawned companies offering blood transfusions from younger individuals. Companies such as Ambrosia and IV Plasma, started by Dr. Jesse Karmazin, charged north of $8,000 a pop for blood and plasma transfusions. But those who forked over $8,000 to receive blood from young donors may have been better off spending it at a casino. Let me explain. Recent studies have started to tease out whether there are rejuvenating factors, such as the hormone oxytocin, in the young blood, or decreasing pro-aging factors / accumulated damage in the old blood that produce the beneficial effects in these studies. Well, research from the Convoy Lab suggests that simply diluting blood in old mice improved their brain function, decreased inflammation in the brain, improved muscle repair, and decreased fat in the livers. What's more is that several rounds of blood dilutions, termed therapeutic plasma exchange, in old individuals greater than 60 years old, reduced their biological ages based on many molecular biomarkers. They also found that these individuals had regenerative and anti-cancer factor levels akin to more youthful individuals. All this suggests the reason we age may be largely due to accumulation of pro-aging factors and damage. And finding out what these pro-aging factors are could lead to revolutionary new anti-aging therapies. In the meantime, slowing aging may be as simple as diluting our blood plasma. If the positive findings keep coming, plasma dilution may be one of the most accessible, inexpensive, and low-risk solutions to extend healthy lifespan available. Since the 1930s, when a Swiss scholar first showed that skin cells can be rejuvenated by injecting living cells into the patient, scientists have been trying to figure out how to delay aging with cell therapy. One of the most promising types of cell therapies is with stem cells, of which there are many types. With embryonic stem cells and induced pluripotent stem cells having the most potential to extend healthy lifespan in humans. It becomes even more dire to understand how stem cells work, since as we age, our stem cells decrease in number and ability to function, reducing the abilities of our organs to work properly and prolonging tissue repair. Embryonic stem cells are cells that can change or differentiate into any type of cell in the body. However, their use is contentious given that they are obtained from embryos. Thankfully, iPSCs have been discovered, which can be made from non-embryonic sources but still have most properties of ESCs. Stem cells show massive promise at treating age-related diseases in animal models, such as Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, heart failure, and arthritis. Stem cells have also shown lots of potential in humans as well, showing at least some success for treating heart disease, liver disease, eye disease, arthritis, cancer, and even infectious diseases, where one study found an improved survival rate in COVID-19 patients. That's all great, but can they also extend the lifespan? Well, it turns out they can, at least when aged stem cells are rejuvenated. One group of scientists have shown that they can rejuvenate blood stem cell function in mice with casein, a molecule that blocks the CDC42 enzyme. 4 days of this treatment in aged female mice lowered inflammation, produced a younger epigenetic clock, and extended maximum lifespan. They also show that casein-treated mice perform better than non-treated mice in endurance and strength tests. Astonishingly, transplanting rejuvenated blood stem cells to older mice that are immunocompromised extended their maximum lifespans by 34%. Since casein treatments can also rejuvenate other stem cell types, such as hair follicle and intestinal stem cells, rejuvenating stem cells may be a way to improve health and delay aging. Work is ongoing to find out how stem cells produce their health and longevity benefits, with recent studies suggesting it's through molecules they secrete in special packages called exosomes. It's likely that these molecules heavily overlap with the ones producing benefits in the heterochronic parabiosis experiments. Figuring out what these pro and anti-aging molecules are will lead to the next generation of anti-aging therapies. We'll discuss 4 more promising anti-aging therapies in the next video, so make sure to subscribe.